Hey, it's Fran again, this time with a little instructional video. I wanted to show how to use the Polaroid land camera. I have an article up on the design and engineering page, and there's a link in the description. It shows how I went about mounting the flash bracket on the camera so I could do nighttime photography with the Polaroid. But I wanted to do this little video to show how to load the film and take a shot with the Polaroid. The land cameras are really great cameras, especially for the value. You can get them for next to nothing these days, and the film is still readily available and relatively cheap. So let's load the film in this and take a picture. Okay, so the first thing I'm going to do is get the back of the camera open, which we do by pressing the release lever on the bottom, and that's going to pop the back open, swing it open, and pull out the old cartridge, just yank it out, toss it out, and then I'm going to clean the pinch rollers. Get a piece of a paper towel and just using my thumb to roll the roller, I'm going to be just wipe off all of the dried off residue from the developer that builds up on the rollers. It's very important to clean the camera after every time that you use it, because the buildup will not only cause the rollers to corrode, but it'll also interfere with the processing if that builds up. Okay. I'm going to get a new pack of film. This is the 100 speed film. Just break the foil open and pull the cartridge out. Pretty simple. I actually store this film in my refrigerator. It'll keep for a very long time if you refrigerate it. And I bring it up to temperature before putting it in the camera. Just pop it in. It's a nice tight fit, and it'll just snap right into the back of the camera. You want to make sure that that all of the paper tabs are also out and not folded under. Make sure they're out. And here's a little trick. Before you actually snap the back shut, wiggle the light seal out a little bit. You just want to get it started, because I find that if you don't start it before you snap the back shut, it might tear in half, because it's very hard to pull out. Pull out the whole light seal, and go, and keep going. Keep pulling it out, and there you go. It's the whole light seal. You just toss that out. And also check that the number one tab should now be visible, which shows that the first piece of film is loaded in the camera and ready to be exposed. Yep, it's ready to go. To open up the camera, you push up on the number one tab and you can pull out the bellows until it snaps in the full forward position. And secondly, you push down the shutter lever. It's a good idea to do that in advance of taking the picture, particularly if you haven't recapped the electronics. It gives a little time for it to charge up. Well, my azaleas are in bloom, so I figure I'm going to take a picture of my azalea bush. And first thing is check the shutter. It is ready to go. I set the exposure about midway because it's a semi-overcast day, and the middle exposure is about right for cloudy, overcast day. The focus bar is right there. Those two little tabs slide back and forth to focus, and you set the focus by looking into the focus aperture, and inside you're going to see two images of what you're going to photograph, and you just line them up so that they overlap and take your shot. Now we're going to be ready to develop here, and keeping an eye on a clock with a second hand, you're going to pull out the paper tab, the small paper tab, and that's going to pull out a number two tab, which shows the second one is going to be ready, and also a larger tab, and the larger tab is actually the picture that you just shot. And so keeping an eye on a clock to make note of your time, you grab the large tab and pull it out nice and slow. Now what it's just done is it's broken a reservoir of developer and run it, when it goes through those pinch rollers, the pinch rollers evenly distribute the developer across the whole picture. Now, contrary to myth, shaking Polaroid does not make it develop faster, but it is temperature sensitive. So it's about 73 degrees, so I'm going to develop for 60 seconds. If it were colder, what I could do is wrap the photograph in a paper towel and actually hold it between my hands to warm it up a little bit, and I would cut the development time probably in half. But we're going to go for 60 seconds. And in anticipation of opening up the picture from the developer, I'm going to tear the wax paper and grab the backing, and at 60 seconds I will remove the backing with the developer. And that's all wet, and I'm just going to put that right in the trash. And then grabbing the corner of the actual photograph, I'm going to pull off the edge mask. That will peel off. And this will continue to develop for the next minute or so and get darker and higher in contrast. And while it develops and dries, you just want to lay it on a flat surface. And over the course of about 15 minutes, the resin coating will harden and your photograph will be ready to handle. And there you go. There's my azaleas in living Polaroid color. I'm Fran. Thanks for watching. Bye.